This video is provided as supplementary material for courses taught at Howard Community College. And in this video, I want to show how to determine whether a graph of a rational function will intersect its horizontal asymptote. So here's the first problem. I've got this rational function f of x equals x minus 4 over x squared plus 2x minus 15. I want to find out whether its graph will intersect its horizontal asymptote. So the first step is going to be to find out what the horizontal asymptote is. When you've got a rational function and the degree of the polynomial in the numerator is less than the degree of the polynomial in the denominator, that's what I've got here, then the horizontal asymptote is going to be zero. So what we're going to do is this. We're going to take this expression, this rational expression, x minus 4 over x squared plus 2x minus 15, and set it equal to the horizontal asymptote. And then we want to find out whether there are any values of x that will make this expression, that will make this fraction, equal the horizontal asymptote. Now, in this case, it's going to be fairly easy. When you've got a fraction, if you can make the numerator of the fraction equal to zero, the whole fraction will be equal to zero. Since the numerator that I've got here is x minus 4, if x were to equal positive 4, the numerator would be zero, and the whole fraction would be zero. So this graph will intersect the horizontal asymptote at zero. In fact, it will intersect it when x is 4, and so the place where it intersects it will be at the point 4, comma 0. Okay? Let's look at a few more. This is function g of x. G of x equals x minus 7 over x plus 5. And once again, it's a rational function. We want to see if it's going to intersect its horizontal asymptote. So, first, we have to find what the horizontal asymptote is. Both the numerator and the denominator are degree 1 polynomials. When the degrees are the same and the leading coefficients are the same, and they are, they're both a leading coefficient of 1, then the horizontal asymptote is going to equal 1. So we'll take this expression, x minus 7 over x plus 5, and we'll set it equal to the horizontal asymptote, which is 1. And we want to see if we can make that expression, make that fraction equal to 1. Okay, so what I'm going to do is multiply both sides by x plus 5. When I do that, I'll get x minus 7 equals x plus 5. I could subtract 6 out of both sides of the equation. I could subtract x out of both sides. So I'll just cross the x's out. And what I'm left with is negative 7 equals positive 5. Now, that doesn't make sense. It doesn't make sense because this fraction is never going to equal 1. So in this case, the graph of the rational function is not going to intersect its horizontal asymptote. In other words, the rational function will never equal the horizontal asymptote. Let's take a look at one more. This one is h of x equals x squared over 3x squared plus 2x plus 4. So what I want to do first is find out what the horizontal asymptote is. Both the numerator and the denominator are second degree polynomials. The numerator has a lead coefficient of 1. The denominator has a lead coefficient of 3. So the horizontal asymptote is 1/3. I'll take this expression, x squared over 3x squared plus 2x plus 4, and set it equal to the horizontal asymptote. And then I want to see if I can make this fraction on the left equal the horizontal asymptote. I want to see if I can make it equal 1/3. So I can simplify this equation by cross-multiplying. I'll multiply 3 times the x squared, and I'll get 3x squared. And then I'll multiply this 3x squared plus 2x plus 4 by 1. So I'm going to have 3x squared plus 2x plus 4. And let's see if we can simplify that equation. I've got 3x squared on both sides, so I can subtract them out. I can just cross them out. I'll have 0 equals 2x plus 4. I'll subtract 2x from both sides. That will give me negative 2x equals 4. And so when I divide both sides by negative 2, I'll get x equals negative 2. And so it looks like the graph for this function, for this rational function, is going to cross, it's going to intersect the horizontal asymptote, which is 1/3, when x equals negative 2. So the point where that's going to happen is going to be at negative 2, comma, 1/3. Okay, so the procedure for all of these is basically the same. You first find out what the horizontal asymptote is. Then you take your rational expression and set it equal to that horizontal asymptote. And then you see if you can solve that equation to find a value of x that will make this whole equation balance. If you can do that, that value of x is going to be the point, the x value, where your graph crosses or intersects the horizontal asymptote. Okay? And that's about it. Take care. I'll see you next time.